How broken are you? They are speaking to children of God who I believe they are born again. I believe they are ready for heaven. So this morning, the Lord is asking me, are you? You have asked me, and I've done what I'm supposed to do. So this morning, he's also asking you, how broken are you as a daughter of his or as a son of his? And we all know for you to be a true Christian, you must be a broken Christian. Now, it means Christians are broken categorically. Some are broken, but yet there are some things they cannot still do, but they are saying they are broken to some level. This morning, the Bible told us in Psalm 24 from verse 15 to 17. See, the eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and his ears open unto their cry. The eyes of the Lord is upon the righteous, and his ears is open unto their cry. Verse 16. The face of the Lord is against them that do evil, to cut off the remembrance of them from the earth. The face of the Lord is against them that do evil, to cut them off from the earth. 17. The righteous cry, and the Lord heareth them, and deliver them out of all their troubles. Verse 18. The Lord is near unto them that are of broken heart, and save such as be of a contrite spirit. Praise Master Jesus. The Lord heareth them. The Lord heareth them. The Lord is near unto them that are of a broken heart, and save such as be of a contrite heart. Now, the question is, how broken are you? Is the Lord near to you? Is the Lord close to you? Is the Lord there with you? For the Lord to be there with you, you must be a Christian that has a broken heart, an easy accessible Christian. And remember, he said to us, his eyes is upon those who are doing evil. That means when you are not a broken heart Christian, the eyes of the Lord is against you for evil. Praise Master Jesus. Now, I'm
Hallelujah.
going to see something today which will make you know if you are a broken Christian or not. Now, for you to be a broken Christian, you ask yourself a question, which I've asked myself also. As a broken heart Christian, or as a Christian, you ask yourself, can I easily say I'm sorry when I offend anybody, or I forgive you when someone offend me and ask me, tell me I'm sorry? This is a question we should ask ourselves. Can I easily tell somebody I am sorry whenever I wrong somebody? No matter the level I've placed myself, no matter who I think I am in Christendom or in society, as a child of God, can you easily realize that you have made a mistake? You have offended someone and say, I am sorry, even in the public or even to an individual. Or when somebody offends you, and the person comes to you and say, hey, sorry for what I've done, will you easily say, okay, I forgive you from the bottom of your heart? And take a broken Christian to do this, to know that you have offended somebody and say, I am sorry. You are not proud. You are not lofty. You are not an egocentric Christian. But today, many Christians are like that. And we are saying we are marching to Zion. I wonder the Zion you are going to. Only the broken Christian can access the kingdom of God. Remember what the Bible told us in Philippians chapter 2, verse 5. Say, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Jesus Christ, no matter what you do to him, If you can say, Lord, I am sorry, immediately he will forgive you. But today, many Christians are not that way. They cannot forgive, neither can they say, I am sorry. And they are saying, I want to make heaven. They are saying, Lord, the Lord is with me. I wonder the Lord is with you. It's your great-great-grandfather who was a native daughter that is with you. It's not God. It's the devil that is with such a person. Satan is manipulating you, camouflaging you, and you are saying, God is with me. He is not God. When the time comes, you will know the God who was with you. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Could I easily say, I'm sorry? Or can I easily say, I'll forgive you when I have been bacon on? Now, another one again. Can we easily confess to each other? No matter the magnitude of what you have done, hey, Apostle Abraham, I have done this. So I never need to do it. Okay, we say it over. Can you easily, even to your husband, to confess that sin to him? Hey, my love, I have done this. But because of your ego, of your egocentric, no, I will not say it. It will be a letdown to me. For me to tell my child, I am sorry. Or for me to confess sin to my child. For me to confess sin to somebody, it will be a letdown. What eyes would they to look me? Oh, you are forgotten. If there are president in hell, nobody care about them anymore. Everyone in hell are naked. You better know that one now. You must. For you to be a broken Christian, you must learn to confess sin to each other. The Bible told us in James 5:16, confess your faults one to another. Broken Christians, confess your sins one to another and pray one for another. I wonder how I can pray with you when you are holding grudges with me. I wonder how the prayer will go. I wonder how you can even pray when there's something in your mind. Confess your faults one to another. As husband and wife, we must learn to confess our fault to each other. As Christians that are running the same race, we are saying we are going to the same heaven. We must learn to confess our sin to each other without hesitation. Praise Master Jesus and pray for one another that you may be healed. Many people are sick. They think they are living. They are sick. Their spiritual life is sick. Their soul is sick. Their spirit is sick. Because they can still walk on the street, they think they are okay. But they are sick, they are about to die. They are about to be pushed into hell. If they don't repent, they will know that they have been sick for so long. The Lord was waiting for them to heal themselves, but they vehemently refused to heal themselves, that you may be healed. The effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. How can you be a righteous man when you have things in your heart against somebody? How can you proclaim righteousness when your heart is as full of sepulchre, when your heart is as dustbin? Facially, you might be beautiful, you might be handsome, but your heart is as dirty because of the evil you have packed in your heart. You have hatred for people, and you're saying you're a Christian. I wonder, what kind of Christian are you? How broken are you? The Lord is looking for a broken Christian. Christian that he can easily assess. If man cannot assess you, how can God assess you? Man that you can see cannot assess you. Is it God that cannot see that will assess you? No, you are missing it. You ask yourself. Now, let me tell you something. God values your soul more than your money. He values your soul more than your gift. He values your soul more than whatever you're going to offer him. That's why he told us in Matthew chapter 5, verse 33 to 34. Matthew chapter 5, 33 to 34. Says, therefore, if thou bring thy gift to the altar, even when you have got it to the altar, there remember that thy brother had out against thee, what do you do? Will you offer the please that person, Apostle Brent, please? Will you offer the gift? Say no. Leave that gift before the altar there. Don't offer it. Don't give that gift. Don't give that offering. Don't give that tithe. Drop it there and go that way. First, be reconciled to thy brother, and then come back again and offer that gift. Because if you give with that, when your heart is as full as sepulchre, you are wasting your time. You are wasting your time. The Lord value your soul more than your gift. It's your soul. The Bible says, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and live in health, even as thy soul prospered. 3 John 2. So, the Lord is telling you and I today, no matter what you give to Him, no matter what you offer, it is offered in out of dirty heart. Say, you are doing nothing but you are working against yourself. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And go back to your brother. Go back to your sister. Go back to your husband. Go back to whosoever you are having grudges with. Reconcile with that person. And come back again. Then you will not be free to offer the offering or whatever you are giving. Else, it will be an iniquity to you. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Pray with hatred at heart is waste of time. Praying with hatred at heart is waste of time. You have hatred in your heart and you are praying. You are wasting your time. Satan is the one that is absorbing that prayer. You are only wasting your time. Brother and sister, the Lord has sent me this morning to talk to everyone of God. It's about to change your story to glory. It cannot be done. Even though you spend 100 years being honest, if you have something in your mind against your brother, you are wasting time. You are not broken. The Lord is near to people who their heart is broken, who are easily accessed. But you, if it's not so, just sit down and go and just start doing party up and down, because you are wasting your time. Whatever you say you are doing in the household of God is a time wasted. Praise Master Jesus. As I said before,
praying
with hatred at heart is waste of time, waste of energy, waste of resources. Mark 11:25. And when you stand praying, forgive. When you stand praying, forgive. If you have aught against any, that your Father also, which is in heaven, may forgive you your trespasses. Because it's from forgiveness the Lord will not bless you. Before God bless you, will assess your file. If you see that there's anger or quarrel in your file or malice, it will not give you that blessing. You are only wasting your time. So the Lord Jesus Christ is telling you, before you can boldly stand before Him, as I say, Father, bless me. Give me this. Give me that. You must forgive those people that have offended you. And you must also forgive yourself. Some people are so cruel to the extent that they cannot even forgive themselves. Not even talk of forgiving somebody else. Praise Master Jesus. The Bible told us, chapter 6 from verse 12, and forgive us our debt as we forgive our debtors. Forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Have mercy on us, O Lord, as I've had mercy upon somebody. Bless me, O Lord, as I am a blessing to somebody. Praise Master Jesus. Verse 13. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. 14. For if you forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. It's give and take. Trade by barter. Give and take. Before you ask God, give to me, you must have check a record. Do you also give? Father, forgive me, I've held against you. Have you forgiven that person I've held against you? If you do not, I will not also forgive you. Verse 15. But if you forgive not, men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses also. Can't you see? So, you must be broken to be able to do this. So remember, as you're about to pray now, I have to check myself. Is there anybody in my heart that I'm having any grudges with? I better forgive now. Hey, my sister, I have nothing against you anymore. My brother, I did this. Forgive me. That is true life of a Christian. Easy access Christian. Somebody who is mad or her mother is easily open to say, I have done this. I am sorry. I have forgiven you. But today, many Christians, even pastors, they don't do it. Though they can preach it, but they never do it. And I pray, God will have mercy in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
True faith starts from forgiveness. Amen. True faith.
Amen.
You want to have faith in God. You want your faith to move mountain. You must learn to forgive and to say, I am sorry. It takes faith to say, I forgive you. It takes faith to say, I am sorry. The Bible says in Luke chapter 17, verse 3, take heed to yourselves. If thy brother trespass against thee, rebuke him. Rebuke him. And if he repent, forgive him. Rebuke him. Let him know that he have offended you. My brother, what you did not, I don't like it. I will say, hey, my brother, I'm sorry. Immediately, forgive. Okay, I heard you. Verse 4. And if he trespass against thee seven times in a day, and seven times in a day turn again to thee, saying, I repent, thou shalt forgive him. This is why we sin against Christ by second bill. And every time we ask God, Father, please have mercy. He keeps forgiving us. But today, many Christians, pastors, deacons, 10 years they have out against somebody. For 10 years, they are not forgiven. 6 years, 3 months, 2 months, 2 days, a day, an hour. And the person say, I have, please forgive me for where. Sometimes they're even the one at wrong, yet they hold on to the right because they are destining themselves to hell. And I pray, God will have mercy today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Verse 5. And the apostle says, I'm reading Luke 17, and the apostle said unto the Lord, increase our faith. It takes faith to do this. A faithless man cannot do this until you have faith in God. You not trust that it's only God that can help you in everything. Without God, you are nothing. If you believe, except you're a man of yourself, if you believe that God is all and all in your life, you must be humble. You must be broken. Yes, you are a man of yourself. And the apostle says, increase our faith, O Lord. Verse 6. And the Lord said, if you have faith as grain of mustard seed, you may say unto this second tree, be thou plucked up up by the roots, and be thou planted in the sea, and it shall obey you. For all these things to obey you, you must obey the law of forgiveness. It starts from forgiving your neighbors. For you to come and start commanding, I command this sickness to go. You demon, go. Hey, if there's anything in you, if any grievance is in you, there's any hatred in you, you are in trouble. For you to command this thing to go away, you must check yourself. First of all, for you to have the faith to command sickness to go, first of all, have the faith to forgive one another. First of all, have the faith to tell somebody, I am sorry, or I have forgiven you. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Now, you must be kind and forgiving to be like Christ Jesus. Therefore, I want to be like Jesus in my heart. In my heart, hey, it's not just so. You work for it. If you want to be like Christ in your heart, you must learn to forgive and to say, I am sorry. Philippians 4, verse 31 to 32. Say, let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. Let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. Verse 32. And be kind one to another, tender hearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake had forgiven you. Even as God for Christ's sake forgiving you. Praise Master Jesus. Do we want to be like Jesus? We must learn to forgive. According to the book of 2 Corinthians 2, verse 16, we must learn to forgive one another. You want to be a commando. You want to be a pace setter. You must learn to forgive and to say, I am sorry. Colossians chapter 3, verse 10. And he put on, and he have put on the new man, which is renewed in Christ. I come again. Colossians 3, from verse 10. And have put on the new man, which is renewed in knowledge after the image of him that created him. 11. Where there is neither Greek nor Jew, circumcision nor uncircumcision, barbarian, Scythian, bond nor free, but Christ is all and all in all. Verse 12. Put on, therefore, as the elect of God, as the elect of God, holy and beloved, boy of mercies, kindness, humbleness of mind, meekness, long suffering. These are the criterion to be a broken heart Christian. These are the prerequisites to be a true Christian. Verse 13, forbearing one another and forgiving one another. If any man have a quarrel against any, even as Christ forgive you, so also do ye. But many are saying, no. I am the Christ of myself. That Christ I'm talking about, I don't know that one. I am the Christ of myself. I died for myself. On the last day, we shall see and we shall know. Praise Master Jesus. The Bible says, I'm talking about that. This is a reference. 1 Corinthians 16:16. I mean, 2:16. For who have known the mind of Christ, of the Lord, that he might instruct him. But you have the mind of Christ. Is that true? You have the mind of Christ where your mind is full of envy, of jealousy, of malice, of things that are not supposed to be there. Say, no. We must learn to forbear one another, forgiving one another. If any man have a quarrel against any, even as Christ forgive us, even as Christ forgive you, so also do ye. 14. And above all these things, put on charity, which is the bond of perfectness. How can you say you are charitable when you have hatred in your heart? I am a giver. You cannot give love. You're saying you are giving money out of hatred. It is not acceptable. Whatever you give to God, when you have problem or quarrel with any other person, you are wasting your time. You are only giving to the devil that will punish you in hell on the last day. Praise Master Jesus. Verse 15. And let the peace of God rule in your heart, to thee which also you accord in one body, and be ye thankful. How broken are you? Let me tell you something. Even ritualists, they can give khaki. Car, take it. After they have killed. After they have killed human being. They start sharing car. Okay, I give you 10,000 euro. I give you this. It's also giving. So also, children of God today, you have hatred in your heart. You are giving whatever you are giving. It's a waste of time. You are like a ritualist. You are like a courtist. The same thing. So for you to be a genuine giver, for you to be a genuine Christian, you must learn to forgive and to say, I am sorry. Broken. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Peace to have peace. We must learn to give peace to have peace. If you are making life miserable for somebody, your life will be miserable. You are making life unbearable for people. You can never be, you will only pretend to be happy. You are not happy. If you are a man of God, you are carrying your face as if you are not God. You are oppressing people. You cannot be happy. Wherever you are pressing somebody to the wall. You are thinking, hey, let me do him. Let me do it. You are doing yourself. You can never be happy. The Lord will take peace out of you. For you to have peace, you must learn to give peace to people around you. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
12, verse 14. Follow peace with all men and holiness, without which no man can see God. Yes. Where will you see peace when you don't know God? For you to be able to access God. When you say no one can see God, it's not until your eyes open to see Him. As a Christian, you sought to be seeing God at all times. It's in you. The Lord is in you. And how can He be in you? When your heart is dirty, the Lord does not dwell in a dirty place. So you must follow peace with all men. With all men and holiness. That means for you to be holy, holiness comes from peace. If you have checked yourself, I am right with people now. I have checked this person. I don't have any grievance with anybody. When I look at this person, my heart is pure with her. My heart is pure with this person. Then you can say, okay, now I have peace now. I am living a holy life. Not just by singing it. I want to live a holy life. God save my soul. It's not by singing it. It's by practicing it. We are in the era of practical Christianity. Praise Master Jesus. No man can see God unless you are peaceful, unless you are holy. John 13, verse 35. John 13, 35. Say, by this shall all men know that you are my disciples if you love one another. How can you love somebody who you are not forgiven? It's not possible. How can you say, I love Apostle Abraham, when I have something in my mind that I have not told him? It's a lie. I'm only walking my way to hell. How can I say, I love Sister Caroline, when I know there's something she did some time ago, and it's in my heart, I'm not voicing it out for her? It's a lie. I am only walking majestically, smiling to hell, and I can never have peace in that way. And whenever you want to formulate joy in your heart, Satan will remind you. He will always put that in your mind. So therefore, the Lord is telling us today, let us pour out our heart to each other. Let us forgive each other. If you want your story to change to the glory of God, you must first of all work on yourself. This is personal assessment. Assess yourself now. Am I a broken Christian? Or I am a stony Christian? If you are a stone-hearted Christian, the Lord have nothing to do with you. You are a castaway. You are already in hell while you are still living. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
This is a closing remark. 1 John 1:9. If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. But for you to go to God and confess your sin before the Lord, first of all, check yourself. Have I confessed my sin before my wife? Have I confessed my sin before my husband? Have I confessed that sin before so person I've helped? If you have not done so, forget about it. Forget about it. You must first of all clean with the person you can see before you can go to the God of the Spirit. Praise Master Jesus. The question, how broken are you? Am I broken enough to say I am sorry. Forgive me. Oh, okay. I have forgiven you. Genuinely, from your mind. If you are able, to, if you have gotten to this level, heaven is close to you. That's just a step to make you get to heaven. But if you have not got to this level, I'm telling you, you are still very, very far from heaven. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
See what our brother did that day. Came out openly. Say, I am sorry for what I did, for saying that word. I am sorry. But not everybody can do so. Not every man of God will say, hey, what I said yesterday, hey, it was wrong. I said it out of my heart. No. I better bear it and go to hell. That is a problem today. Many people know what they did is wrong. But because I don't start charity to be looking down on me, I better respect myself and hold it on. But meanwhile, you are on your way to hell. I pray the Lord will help everyone of us to know the right thing to do. Even if it's your little child that you offended, tell your child, I am sorry. Tell your brother, I am sorry. Tell your church member, I am sorry. Let's learn to tell each other, I am sorry. Our life will be better. Let us learn to smile, come from the heart. Some people, they know how to fabricate. The Lord knows those who are fabricating. Some people are sick in their spirit, sick in their soul, but they are just manifesting the joy. It's not complete until the Lord have made it complete. And how can the Lord do it? When you now get to that level of saying, I am sorry and I have forgiven you. May the Lord bless his word. Now, how this morning? This is the word of just short exhortation. And I pray you go back to your home now, check yourself, and check myself. Put pen and paper on the ground and check people who you have say I will never forgive. You better forgive them. Those you have offended, call them and tell them, my sister, my brother, in so time, I did this. I did that. Forgive me. And the Lord will take your name away from the book of death and write it in the book of life. May the Lord bless his word in our hearts in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Are you there? You are not born again. That means you have not forgiven yourself. You are still an enemy to yourself. I want you to please forgive yourself now and run to our Lord Jesus Christ. Except a man is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. That is the starting point of being a Christian. John 3:3. After me, if you want to accept our Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. Say, Lord Jesus, I've heard a word this morning. I realize how dirty I am. But I've come to you today. Forgive me all my sins. And I've forgiven all that have sinned against me. Wash me clean with your blood. Purge me from every unrighteousness. Take my name away from the book of death and write it in the book of life.
Thank you, Jesus.
I accept today
book of death and write it in the
book of life. As my Lord and personal Savior.
Father, my Lord,
I am born again today. All things have passed away. And all things have become new. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, for bringing your word to my way this morning and for saving my soul. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This is the word of the Lord. Check yourself. If you must call that your sister-in-law, your father-in-law, your mother-in-law, call them and know what to do about them. Call that your brother, call that your sister, and tell them, forgive me, or I have forgiven you. With them, that your name will be among the saints that are going to heaven. God bless you all. The name bless in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless the possible name. Over to you.
God bless you, sir.
Amen.
So praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.